Good morning, class. We are continuing the lesson number 11A, that is about the national movement, the early phase from the period of 1916. In the previous class, we have been getting to know about the from the before of 1985, what it was, been existed, how in detail. Now, lesson number 11A. The national movement the early phase
Traders.
been elected. So in year after year, these delegates were 4,436 delegates elected. So before in the year 75, it was only 75 delegates first year. Now second year 436, and this number meetings been the meeting it will be going. The meetings were held in December every year. Moderate leaders, they say that the Indians also need to be getting IAS, IPS, IFS, IRS. So all these are the administrative services works. They are being well qualified, and then we are going to get the administrative post, which is being related to the government functioning and the working. So same this will happen on the British period of time here, but it is only under single power, that is about the monopolized by the British, and they have been making discrimination on the basis of racism. So here these modern nationalist leaders, they want the Indians to be included in the administrative, that is legislative council making, without any racial discrimination, and the civil services examinations also need to be get conducted in India irrespective of the London. So now who are the leaders? Leaders like Nauroji, Archie Gupta and Ranade studied the economic impact of the British rule and concluded that the British were draining India for her wealth and through taxes, another means and making her poorer and poorer. They drew attention to the problems of poverty and famine and blamed it on the British policies of excessive land revenue, export of food grains, etc. Now this is about the administrative work. Now next is coming to the economic. Economics means related towards the money matters, development. Economic, it leads to the development. So in this way, here also the British were using excessive, like the policies, like what are the policies here? Land revenue, collecting of the taxes, then next export, importing, export of the grains, exporting of the food grains, then at the same time natural resources, exploiting the natural resources. In this modern phase, there are intellectuals, other important leaders who have been well educated. So in this figure, there were three economists, the persons who knows about the development, who deals about the country's development. Economists, the persons have been known as. They will see the, how the country is been developing, how the country's income it has been using for the development. So that is what known as the economic, means related to the development of the country. In that aspect, done the by Nauroji, and he has been known as the economist person. And this Archie Gupta and Ranade. So all these three persons have been studied about India's economic aspect for the development. So in this regard, they have been being aware, like how the British have been using, collecting more revenue from the farmers, excess money. Then is exporting the food grains. What we have been producing, our country, our farmers, that have been exporting to their country. Then makes it. So in this regard, land revenue is money towards to their country. Food grains, not to our country people, towards to the British. So in this way, if they are draining India's complete wealth through taxes, through other means, taxes means revenue, other means exporting the food grains, exporting the raw material, exporting the national resources, all in this way, and it will be going to lead the people, lead the country into the poorer and poorer aspect. And that has to lead to the problem of famines, lead to the problem of poverty. The Congress passed many resolutions on the salt tax, treatment of Indian laborers abroad, and the suffering of forest dwellers caused by an interacting forest administration. So after saying all this, even though this Congress is ANC, these delegates, the members who have been elected, they also need to pass a resolution, means giving out the petition, giving out their opinion in the Legislative Council about the workers who have been working abroad. Means in their countries, the workers who have been working, how their working conditions, how they have been treated. So regarding that, then salt law is where the common food item essentially is about the salt. So in that also the taxes been get paid. The people who have been consuming the purchasing the salt, the taxes also been need to pay. So salt through the seas, through the water bodies we can make, naturally we can make out the salt. So in that also, the taxes has been levied. The people need to pay the taxes. Then next, at the same time, we also need know about the forest dwellers suffering. What forest dwellers? Forest dwellers, since the person, the tribal people or the people who have been living in the forest, deforestation, for the use of the wood, for the use of the natural resources. They are being living homeless. The land will be completely barren. So regarding these three also, like suffering of the workers abroad, sufferings of the forest dwellers, then at the same time they also been taxes on the salt also. So all this regarding aspect, the Congress has been passed a resolution in the Legislative Council of the Britishers. The early industry convenience of the need for national industrial development to end poverty in India. So what is actually they want? United people at the same time economic development, not through this manner. They want economic development through industrial development. So industrial development, how the people need to get united, they need to be work for the industrial development. So if all the workers have been getting the work, no kind of at least to the no kind of poverty or the famines, so that India can also be need to be get developed in the industrial aspect. However, the British rule was standing in the way of development, as they were not only trading India's wealth to England but also enabling selling of the British good at cheaper rates in India and assisting Indian craft and industries. This was not as the modern aims, nationalist aims are very good. So they want the development in the administrative aspect, in the economic aspect, but in the economic aspect, as already the England, the British, they were draining India's wealth. Using up. In the letter, the India's craft bosses in industries, the goods are whatever the goods are being made out. The Indian people are being, they can purchase, but in what way the British have been done the policies like their country's goods, what the craft goods or the industrial goods, they are selling in India at very cheap prices. So why the Indian people will purchase the country's craft goods or the industrial goods? It will be a little more of more cost. But the same product or the same thing, the British, they are selling at the cheaper prices. So that is also being one kind of obstacle for the economic development. In what way? It goes with the losses again. To the people who are the craft persons, to the person who are being manufacturing the industrial goods, that they go in the losses. In the losses means poverty, no money, and at the same time it needs to go on the land loss, the British. So in this way the economic impact is been happening out and it leads to the poverty and it leads to the famines. Now next here, the modern leaders reach out to people in different parts of the country by holding lectures, meetings and tour. Now what's now the serious mode out, these modern leaders, they will tell these are delegates, workers are moving to different parts of the country to know about the grievances between the rulers, between the Britishers, their economic problems, all. But in that part of places, they started holding the, conducting the meetings, they have been holding the lectures, they have been moving the tours from one place to another place. So in this way, they have been started creating more and more awareness about the Britishers towards to the Indian people by holding different kinds of meetings, lectures, posters, making the tour from one place to the other place. So in this way, they have been creating the environment to reach out the people of different parts of the country. They believe that the Britishers were committed to the freedom and justice and would accept the demands when expressed properly. So now what the modern leaders, nationalists, they were thinking, if we convey our problems, if we say our, like regarding aspects 1943, they were triggered bad harvest, but their consequences were devastating because of the policies of the colonial government. So, by the year, in this period of time, we are going to have a look on now here, 1943. So, 1943 period of time, there was a famine. Famine means the acute shortage of the food grains. Basically, the food grain what we use to consume. So, 1943, 18th century, the Bengal famine has been occurred, and its result was completely very devastating because of the British colonial rule. The government collected huge part of the taxes. The government collected huge part of the produce and tax, which did not leave any buffer to the peasants even in the times of bad harvest. So, in such a way, the British has been used on the harvest. In huge quantity, collected the taxes. In a bulk, the food grains, what the farmers have been growing, the harvest, it was been get collected as a huge part of produce as a form of the tax. After collecting, if this kind of famine has been occurred, even the small part of the harvest is also been not to the farmers. The government also did not intervene by controlling prices or supply of foodstuff during the famines, allowing traders to hold and increase prices. And this is even for the money lenders, even the big landlords, all they were having to food grains with them, the stock holding. In that stock, they will increase the price demand. And at the same time, the trader who have been increasing the prices, the traders, then during the time of period of famines, even the British, they did not control the such kind of activities. In what way? Like landlords, he had to hold the stock of the food grains. During the time of the demand, they increase the prices. Even the farmers, they cannot able to purchase because they have been lost, and because of losses, no money, and because of no money, they cannot able to purchase the food grains, and that food grain prices are also being increased in so high by the landlords and by the traders. And during that period of time, the producers did not bother and they were not controlling the prices. And this has all led to the deaths of millions of people during the famine. And this has been led to the complete of famine. Millions of children and people have been led to face their death due to the shortage of the food grains. And Britishers, they were not at all concerned about what has been happening or what the people are being suffering of. So here, in the next page of 122, two inbox questions is still being given on the blog inbox one. So let's see what are these two questions. So what are these two questions here? Page of 122. First question, why did the early nationalists believe in the British were responsible for the poverty and the famines in India? The next here, why do you think the early nationalists did not want to re-establish the rule of the old kings in India? What it would have been better than the British rule? So these two questions regarding how. Just not getting. So these two. So what are these two here means? Why did the early nationalists? So early nationalists is modern nationalists only. While they have been believed that the British were responsible for the poverty and famines in India. Why these were not why these modern leaders believe? Well, because all the countries in the form of economic development, collection of more of land revenue, exploring the natural resources, then exporting the food grains towards their countries. The next, the economic part of the development activities, which are like manufacturing of the craft goods or the industrial goods, from